हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ फाइमिदा पीजीटी बॉटनी फ्रॉम टीएसएमएस बेजेंकी. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट हेरिडिटी. व्हाट इज हेरिडिटी? हेरिडिटी इज ट्रांसफर ऑफ द कैरेक्टर्स फ्रॉम पेरेंट्स टू देयर प्रोजेनी. नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग इन दिस वीडियो अबाउट इट्स कंटिन्यूएशन चैप्टर, दैट इज अबाउट द डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ द सेक्स इन ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. बट हाउ इज द सेक्स ऑफ ए चाइल्ड इज डिटरमाइंड? Students, the same question might have you gone several times in your mind also. Let us try to find the answer. We human beings inherited our traits from our parents. What is a trait? Trait is a gene. Means our characters. What the characters we are getting, all the characters we got from our parents. Let us see. How is sex determined in the human beings? Each human cell contains how many chromosomes? Total, each human cell contains the 23 pairs of chromosomes. Individually, we can say those are the 46 chromosomes are present in human beings. So, in this 23 pairs of the chromosomes, these chromosomes are divides into the two types. Those are autosomes and allosomes. Autosomes are how many? Autosomes are total 22 pairs. Allosomes are only one pair. Autosomes, these are responsible to give the morphological structure of the body. So there is no difference in the number and morphology of the autosomes, even in the male and also in the female. That means 22 pairs of the chromosomes which are present in both the male and female are similar. There is no difference. But when you come to the allosomes, these are very important chromosomes because these chromosomes only responsible to determine the sex of a human being. That's why we can call them like as the sex chromosomes. So these sex chromosomes responsible to determine the sex of the human beings, because along with the autosomes, means along with the 22 pairs of the chromosomes, a male contain one pair of chromosome. In that one pair of chromosome, they have one X and one Y chromosome. When you come to the females, in female, along with the autosomes, they have one pair of allosomes. Those are two X chromosomes only in their body. So like this, in human beings, total 23 pairs of chromosomes are present. In that 23 pairs of chromosomes, 22 pairs are autosomes. One pair is the allosome. This one pair of allosome is only responsible to determine the sex of the human beings, because male person have one X, one Y chromosome, female person have two X chromosome in their allosomes. Now, all of you see this flow chart. See here, female and male, both are indicated here. In the female body, they have the chromosomes. Those are the XX chromosomes. In male body, they have the XY chromosomes. So it is in which form? It is in the diploid condition. So already we discussed in the heredity chapter what we discussed there. While they are separating into the gametes, must and should be, a zygote is get divided. It will get divided into the individual singular one. Means here two X chromosomes which are present in this zygote, they will get divides into the gametes, like as X gamete. Okay, one ovum contains only one X gamete, another ovum contains another X gamete. When you come to the male, while they are divides into the gametes, in the sperms, one sperm cell contain X chromosome, another sperm cell contain Y chromosome in them. Okay, at the time of the reproduction process, in the reproduction process, while the chromosomes are combines with each other, one X chromosome of a mother, means one X chromosome which is present in the ovum, when it combines with the X chromosome of a father, then it forms a baby girl. If a X chromosome of a mother combines with the X chromosome of a father, then it gives the baby girl. If a X chromosome of a mother ovum is binds with the Y chromosome of a father's sperm cell, then it gives the boy, baby boy. Like this, after the fertilization process, here the girls and boy, babies are formed. Observe carefully this flowchart, and now you decide yourself that who is responsible for the determination of the sex in the human beings. Here see the flowchart carefully and observe. Here mother has always mother contains in the female body, ovum contains always the X chromosomes only. But when you come to the male, in the sperm cells, while they are get divides into the gametes, when the formation of the sperm cells, at the time of the formation of the sperm cells, these zygotic chromosomes are get divides into the gametes, then they will get splitted or divides into the one X gamete, another Y gamete. So if father's X chromosome is combines with the mother's X chromosome, then it is giving the, obviously it will give the baby girl. If father's Y chromosome is combines with the mother's X chromosome, obviously it will give the baby boy. So here, by this topic, I think all the students, you will get a point of that, who is responsible for the determination of the sex, means who is responsible for the birth of a baby boy or a baby girl. That is nothing but only the male person, only the father is responsible to give the birth of a baby boy. If the father's X is combines with the mother's ovum X, that gives the girl. If the father's sperm Y chromosome combines with the mother's ovum X, that gives the boy. Okay, I think all of you get the proper idea who is responsible for the baby boy and baby girl. Now I think all of you have a point of that, how is the sex of a baby is get determined. Now give the answers to these questions. What will happen if the sperm containing X chromosome fertilizes the ovum? What will happen, ma? If the sperm, if it contains the X chromosome in that, then it fertilizes with the ovum. What will happen here? Who will born? Which kind of the baby will born here? A girl baby or a boy baby? Okay. X chromosome if combines with the, obviously mother has X only. Okay. If the father's X is combines with the mother's X, then what it forms? XX means girl. Who decides the sex of the baby? Mother or the father? By this total description of the determination of the sex, I think all of you get the idea. Who is responsible to decide the sex of the baby? Mother or a father? Sex of the baby is determined by the father. Is the sex also a character or a trait? Does it follow Mendel's law of dominance? Is the Mendel's law of dominance is followed here? No. Here, individually, chromosomes are get separated. Okay. Were all your traits similar that of your parents? You have all the traits, no? Traits means nothing but the genes. Are all the similar with your parents? Like this, here, so many questions will be raised in your mind. I think all of you get cleared about that. Who is responsible to give the birth of a baby boy in your society? and also in your surroundings, you educate the people. Most of the people have a myth that only the mother is responsible to give the birth of a baby. But she is not responsible, only male person is responsible to give the birth of a baby. All of you get educate yourself and also educate in your family and in your society also. Spread your knowledge, because most of the women are harassed by this silly reason. They don't know, they doesn't have the prayer proper knowledge, that's why they are harassing their females and ladies who are present in their family. Now all of you educated, well educated, now all of you understood what was the reason behind that, and now you go and educate in your society. Thank you, ma. I hope all of you understood what is the sex determination and who is responsible for the sex. Thank you. Fahimida.